Transit, how y'all feeling? Y'all, come on, the 9 a.m. was louder than you. I said, Transit, how y'all feeling? Yes, that is what I'm talking about. Hey, if you don't know me, my name is Brendan. Can everybody just say, hey, Brendan? Hey. Hey guys, good to see you. And I am so glad that you're here. If it's your first time, I just want to let you know that you matter and you belong here in Transit. And in Transit, we like to have a lot of fun. We like to do a lot of fun things here. And one of the most fun things that we do all year long is happening this weekend and next Sunday. Does anybody know what that is? What is it? Double Dog Dare. Y'all are 100% right. You did a great job. So, Double Dog Dare is happening this weekend. Now, what is it? It is a time where you're gonna do a bunch of dares with one of your friends on Saturday night. And then on Sunday, we're gonna announce the winners of those dares. And if you won, you're gonna get an epic prize. Now, if you're not registered, make sure to register this week so it'll save you time on a Saturday. But today, we're actually gonna play a game with one of the prizes that you could win next Sunday. So to do that, I've got my friend Maggie hopping on up here. Y'all give it up for Maggie. Give it up for her. Yes, Maggie, the wig looks phenomenal. Is this like part of your daily attire? Is that part of your like daily outfit, that wig?
Yes.
It is. All right, so this is Maggie. I want everybody on the count of three to say, hey, Maggie. One, two, three. Hey, Maggie, welcome. We're gonna have you come over here to the center of the stage, right here. All right, now, one of the epic prizes that you could win at Double Dog Dare is a VR headset. So here it is right here. So Maggie's gonna show us one of the games that we could play on this VR headset today. So it is called Beat Saber. You're gonna have to turn a little bit this way. There you go, perfect. All right, so we're gonna cheer her on as she plays this. She's gonna get this set up. You're gonna be able to see the game on the screen. All right, so Maggie, are you seeing the game? You feel pretty good about it? All right, they're about to. So as soon as you hit start, they're gonna be able to see what you see. All right, you hit that right now, and we're gonna get up on the screen. So you're gonna go in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, she's about to do it. What does it say? Nice. Just say yes to everything. There we go. Now you got it. All right. You go when you're ready. All right. Everybody's going to have to cheer her on when this starts too, okay? You got it. Restart. And there it is. Is it going? All right. I think you got it. All right. You're going to hit this back button. Yep. There it is. Nice. All right, there it is. Y'all give it up for Maggie. All right, y'all cheer her on now. Cheer her on. Let's see it. This is something that you could be doing if you win this next week. Look at that. All right, I know you know this song. Y'all got to sing it. There it is. She's like a pro. She's like a pro. Nice. Hey, come on. Y'all cheer her on. Cheer her on. Come on, make some noise. Make some noise. There you go, Maggie. Absolutely crushing it. All right, Maggie, you're gonna go for like 10 more seconds, like 10 more seconds. You got this. All right, Maggie, great job, great job. You're gonna take that off now. You're gonna take it off. Perfect. Hey, y'all give it up for Maggie. Give it up for Maggie. Hey, you did a great job showing us what this could look like in somebody's house. Hey, Maggie, before you go, I've got this t-shirt for you right here. And then you will notice that Maggie had a wig on before she played that game. That is because we've got the dare wheel outside. Who spun the dare wheel today? Anybody? Anybody? Okay, so we got some banana costumes, all this stuff. It's gonna be amazing next week. You don't want to miss it. So I need every single person in the room to turn to the person next to them, put your hands on their shoulders, start shaking them, and I want you to yell, come to Double Dog Dare. That's right. Let's worship.
11 a.m. Transit. 11 a.m. Transit. How are we feeling this morning? How are we feeling this morning, 11 a.m.? All right, 9 o'clock. They were up here. I have a feeling 11 a.m. is with us. Here we go. Let's sing together. Here we go. You can put those hands up in the air. You know what to do. Let's sing it together.
When I was searching, your love was never far. You made a way to get to me. You were the whisper leading me to your heart. Forever I belong to you.
Surrender feels heavenly. It goes beyond just
You sing it.
Never get tired, never get tired.
Never get tired, never get tired. All you.
Never get tired, never get tired.
Come on, come on. Cause you are worthy and you will always be enough. So I will never get tired of singing of your love. Cause you are worthy and you will always be enough.
Oh,
Let's pray together. God, we're so grateful this morning for your word, for the reminder in these songs of who you are, your nature towards us, your love towards us, passionate, never failing Father. And it's a gift to sing to you this morning. Speak to us. Lord, we love these students. In Jesus' name, amen. Transit, thank you so much for singing with us at 11 a.m. We love you. You have a seat.
Up here with you guys. I think that Transit is the best place in the world, certainly the best place to be on Sunday mornings. Hey, if you're here for the first time, welcome. My name is Kate. I'm here for the first time in a long time, so you and me are in this together, and I'm so glad that you're here. Before we jump in, I just want to reiterate something that Brendan told you guys about, which is a little thing that's happening next weekend. Can anyone tell me what it is? You all can tell me what it is. I love that. Double Dog Dare-a-thon, it's happening. It actually starts next Saturday, and the fun is gonna continue all into Sunday morning. It's gonna be the best. It's one of my favorite things that we do. The dares are outrageous. One of my favorite dares is the biggest pile of toenails. Yeah, that's the appropriate reaction. I know. You'd be amazed. Honestly, you'd be amazed. Another one is the most expired thing that you can find in your pantry at home. You think it's just like a couple months old. It's really like a decade old, okay? There's some things that are growing mold in the back of your pantry, and you're going to find them. So it's going to be so fun. You don't want to miss it. You got to be here. You got to bring your friends. We're going to have giveaways. There's going to be food. So you guys, bring your friends, and we will bring the dares, okay? Sound good? All right, so like I said, my name is Kate, and some of you guys know this, some of y'all don't, but I actually moved to California. Has anyone ever been to California? A few of you? Okay, very few of you. Wow, it's awesome out there. You gotta come visit. But yeah, my husband and my dog and me, we packed up a U-Haul back in January, and we drove all the way across the country to San Diego, and we have been living there, and it's been awesome. But one of the things that I have noticed in the last 3 months is it is a little hard to make friends. I'll be honest. I get into these conversations with people, and I'm like, I don't know what to do with my hands. I don't know what to say. And my mind is racing. I'm like, oh my gosh, I think I forgot how to talk to people. It has been a really big challenge to go and put myself out there and make friends. And I thought about you guys in this process or on my way home. And I thought, you know what? It can be a lot like that in our faith. Like, you guys have probably felt that a lot of times in your faith, and we're in the middle of this series that's talking all about how to share your faith. And I think a lot of times one of the roadblocks that we hit is this right here, that I'm just not sure what to say. That I have these opportunities, I get into these conversations, and it feels like the ball is right on the tee for me to be able to talk about my faith, and then this happens. You're just not exactly sure what to say. Maybe you feel awkward, or maybe you don't want to make things weird between you and your friend, or maybe you feel like, I just don't have enough knowledge about the Bible. Whatever the reason is, we have all felt that before, where we're just not sure what to say in those moments. And the good news is that God doesn't leave it all up to us. Like, he is very much in control. And as you look around at the people in your life, it's not totally your responsibility to make sure that they find themselves in heaven one day, okay? That doesn't all, like, sit on your shoulders, okay? So you can take some comfort in that. But I do think that God really wants us to join into what he's doing. We do have a part that we can play in this bigger story of faith. And really, that comes down to sharing it with other people. So what do we do in those moments? What do we do when we're just not sure what to say? Well, Jesus actually talked about this, and he tells a story, and we call these stories in the Bible that Jesus told, we call them parables. And some of you have heard that word before, maybe some of you haven't heard that word before, but a parable is really just a story. It's when Jesus took kind of a difficult concept. And a lot of times when Jesus talked to these people, these disciples, or these crowds, the things that he was telling these people, like, they were crazy ideas. Jesus stepped onto the scene and he said some wild things. And so to help them really understand what it was that he was talking about, he would share a story. And that story would apply to these people's lives in different ways. So I want to read you this parable, and then we'll make it make sense afterwards, okay? So here's what Jesus said. He said, a farmer went out to sow. And this word sow, it's not like sowing like a needle and thread, okay? Sow just means to scatter your seed, okay? The farmers would go out into the field and they would scatter the crop, okay? A farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path. It was trampled on and the birds ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground. And when it came up, the plants withered because they had no moisture. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up with it and choked the plants. Still, other seed fell on good soil. It came up and yielded a crop, 100 times more than was sown. When he said this, he called out, "Whoever has ears to hear, let them hear." So a few verses later, Jesus actually reveals to us that this seed that he's talking about, those are the words of God, okay? So every time he's referencing the seed in this parable, he's really talking about our words. And we can assume that the places, the various places that he mentions that the seed was falling, that those are actually people in your life, groups of people, maybe individuals. And so what Jesus is getting at here, he's like, hey, you're gonna say a lot of things, and some people are gonna hear what you have to say, and some people aren't. But you're not supposed to worry about the end of the story. You're just supposed to worry about the beginning. And for you, the beginning of that story is just having the courage to share your seed with other people, to make sure that the words that are in your heart are coming out, that you're saying those things, okay? So here's a little visual. I've got these jars, and let's just say for this moment that these jars represent the people in your life, okay? So right here we've got a teammate, someone on your basketball team or your volleyball team. You've got a teammate in your life, and you've wanted to talk to them about God, but to this point, you just haven't figured out how to do that, okay? We'll put your teammate here. And then you've got your brother, maybe your little brother, your older brother, maybe your little sister, your older sister, someone in your family, and they just have this way of annoying you, and so they're the last person you want to talk to about your faith, but you see them literally every day. So we'll put your brother right here. And then you have your classmate at school. You sit next to them in social studies or math class or whatever classes you're in, and you see them every day, and you've wanted to invite them to Double Dog, but you've just been a little bit nervous. Put them here. And then we got Granny, old Granny. Granny, she went to church her whole life, and then all of a sudden maybe she stopped, or maybe she goes to a church now that looks a lot different than your church, and so faith has kind of become this thing that you're just not exactly sure how to talk about it. So Granny's in your life. And then you have just your friends. Some of your best friends, the ones that you spend the most time around, you guys have never talked about your relationship with God. because something pops into your mind and all of a sudden you get so nervous to talk to your own friends about this thing that's a really big part of your life. We'll give them the biggest jar. And then you have this right here, the words of God, okay? These words exist in your heart. You are fully capable of saying them out loud. And what happens is we are responsible for this process. We are responsible for making sure that the seeds, the words of God, that they make it out of our mouth and into the lives of the people around us. And you can see that as I spread out this seed, some of these jars are full. Some of these jars have seeds in them, and these seeds are gonna take root and they're gonna grow. But you also see this mess up here. You see that some of these seeds are on the table. Some of these seeds hit the table and they landed on the ground. They didn't all go exactly where they were supposed to go, but Jesus in this parable, he's saying, don't worry about all that. You just make sure that these seeds come out. You make sure that the words that are in your heart, the experiences that you've had with God, that they get told, that they get shared with the people around you. We have these opportunities, we have these experiences with God, and he hopes that we share them with other people. You have what it takes to share those experiences with other people. Otherwise said is this right here. God has given you everything that you need to be the friend that your friend needs. Let me repeat that. God has given you everything that you need to be the friend that your friend needs. Those words are in there, but your responsibility is just to make sure that they get said. Now, to really help you guys understand this, I wanna invite my friend Kirthan up to the stage to help me. Oh, you're ready. Okay, so Kirthan is gonna help me play a little game, and you guys are gonna play with us. It's a game I like to call Mad Gab. Come right over here, Kirthan, and I'm gonna bring this microphone out. And here's what's gonna happen. Has anyone played Mad Gab? Maybe some of the leaders have, because I feel like it's an old game. Yeah, you have. This was a big game when I was growing up, and here's how it works, okay? On these cards that you can't see, but Kirthan can, there's just a bunch of words, and the words together don't really make sense when you're reading them or when you see them, but when you hear them, AKA when you guys hear what he has to say, you're gonna hear a real phrase, okay? So Kirthan, what I want you to do is actually start by reading the phrase very slowly so they can understand that this is really just a bunch of gibberish, okay? All right, so take this, hold it real close to your mouth and say it nice and loud.
Abe. Less sing.
Okay? So it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, right? But now what I want you to say, and when you hear the phrase, I want you to say it real nice and loud, okay? So say it real quick.
A blessing.
Nice! All right, let's do the next one. This one's a little trickier.
A tray taste who dent.
Now say it fast.
A tray taste. A tray taste student. A tray taste student.
A transit student. Good job. You guys are 2 for 2. All right. Let's see what you got.
See you'll hater.
Yeah, you guys say it. Go ahead.
See you'll hater.
Yeah, see you later. You guys got that one real fast. All right, last one.
Duh, bulldog air.
Double dog air. Okay, you guys did so much better than the 9 a.m., I just have to say. All right, let's give them a round of applause. A little tongue twisted. Great job. So here's why I did that. I wanted you guys to really see and experience that sometimes it feels like gibberish. Like sometimes it feels like, am I even making sense? Like is what I'm saying even landing in the right place? And my encouragement to you is to just be brave and say the thing and let the person decide how they're gonna apply it in their own lives. You can't always decide what the outcome is going to look like, but Jesus is letting you off the hook there. He's just saying, have the courage to say the thing and let him take care of the rest, okay? So let me pray for us, and then there's going to be a special Mad Gabby message for you to instruct you on what to do next, all right? God, thank you so much for Transit. Thanks that all these students have a place where they can come every single Sunday morning and have fun and see their friends and learn more about you, God. I know that it's hard for these students to step into these moments and know what to say. And so I pray that you would just continue to give them opportunities to share their faith. And when they step into those moments, would you just give them the courage to say those words? We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Swimming in the sound, swimming in the sound of love. Don't wanna let you down, don't wanna see you drowning. And when the world's coming down, and there's nobody left but us, you're the designer. Yes, I wanna be a boy at the end of the day. I just wanna keep on saying it.